Final Fantasy 13, huh? A much anticipated title, lots of drama. Exclusive, multiplat, a lot of drama. One disc on the PS3, the superior version. Three discs on the Dur system, right? So what I thought that I'd do this time around is take a look at what other reviewers were saying about the game. Notice I used the term game. It's very close to being a title. But I thought that it was important to correct some of the misconceptions or inaccuracies made by other people who reviewed the game. Right, because I think it's important to like and dislike something for the right reasons. And I'm going to try and be fair with my assessment of Final Fantasy XIII. So, let's start with what was good about the game. What did I like about the game? It's so easy to pick apart things, right? Well, I think that the paradigm system that Square Enix introduced for Final Fantasy XIII was on the right track. It really was. I like the roles. I don't like the way that you flesh out the roles, like how you get experience and learn spells. I didn't like that system at all. But the paradigms were great. It encourages something that most elite MMO players will refer to as stance dancing. And stance dancing is a matter of timing, and timing is, you know, a skill factor. So that is something that I really liked to see, and something that people were promising would be a skill-less game, which I didn't exactly find Final Fantasy XIII to be. I thought that there was a great degree of skill involved. Not as much as I would have liked to have seen, but there were elements there. There were elements. But then you gotta remember, you know, RPGs, they rise to popularity. I mean, I'll give you an example. The back of the booklet for Final Fantasy XIII has a jewelry ad. I mean, it's not high-end jewelry, but it's jewelry, and it's for a reason. RPGs are popular amongst couples. You can play this with your girl. I mean, when guys are playing through it, like me, I'm going to be thinking about form and function, like, is it skill-based? Is this, like, how's the story? How's this? You know, women, and this isn't like a diss to women, but, yo, women who are knockout gorgeous are going to be like, wow, I really like that girl's shoes. They're going to be looking at the outfits, and that's just, you know what? That's just a smart part of Japanese RPGs. They're smart about that. They know that women want to be looking at fashion, and they play to that, and that's cool, that's fine. And there's plenty of that. Believe me, the girls look gorgeous in the game, the outfits are great. You know, your woman, she's going to watch this, she's going to watch you play, she's going to play some of it herself, and she's going to make you buy a necklace from the back of the booklet. Be ready. So here's the thing, right? I would have liked to have seen a bit more skill, but paradigms is kind of where it runs into problems. The paradigms are great, but you can't control where your characters stand on the battlefield, which is incredibly important, especially if you're in situations where you have to tank. And anyone who tanks in MMOs will identify with this. A good tank will face an enemy, especially if an enemy has an AoE cast that's like in a cone or in a limited area. you'll want to either get away from your group or face the enemy away from your group. Or if you're a healer, you're not going to want to stand right, you're not going to want to hug the tank if the enemy has AoE spells. And yet you run into this problem again and again with your party acting stupidly as far as like standing in there. And another thing, you know, people say, you know, Air Sniper, Final Fantasy, for as long as it's been out, has only had like, you know, three people in the party. That's, you know, it's 2010. I want four or five characters in combat. I want there to be more levels of strategy. But then, you know, you're going to lose some of the couple aspect there. So I understand. I understand they can only go so far with, you know, the layers of strategy before they start to lose the casuals and the big money crop. I understand that. It's a business. But then, you know, there should be unlockable difficulties, which, you know, in all fairness, I haven't finished the game. I don't know if there's unlockable difficulties. But from everything that I've read and researched, I'm not seeing that there are. So, you know, in the comments section, let me know if there are. I'm assuming that there aren't. But yeah, I'll correct myself if I'm wrong on that. I have no problem with that. One of the major obstacles of the game was in coding. Some of the boss battles. You know, one thing that I really would have liked to have seen with Final Fantasy XIII is that they could have gotten all of the tutorials out of the way in the first few hours. That would have been better for me. I mean, like, honestly, why not just give people an area to do tutorials and not to leave that area until they feel comfortable? I mean, it's not like they don't have in the menu an area that you can reference the tutorials again. It's there. It's all there. But I really, it was annoying to have to go through tutorial and then do a couple of hours and then another tutorial. It's just, why are you still hitting me with stuff? Like, I should have this all unlocked in the beginning. And then to tell people that they can pick the characters that they want to have in combat and still continue to force players into situations where they're locked into choices made by Square Enix as to what characters to use in combat was extremely annoying. A fatal flaw, in fact. Also, another thing about that is, if you were playing through the storyline and hit a boss for the first time, you were not given the option to go into the Crystarium and level up a character who hadn't been in the party. Like, there were instances where Vanille was thrown into a boss battle where she had not been a part of the storyline, so she was inept. Like, her skills were too low to be in that position, but you wouldn't be able to adjust that unless you lost the battle. You know what I'm saying? So there were and the cutscenes, like the boss battles, would involve like, okay, three cutscenes, then the boss battle. So if you lost the boss battle, you'd have to go through the three cutscenes, then redistribute the ability, the CP points again in the Crystarium, then go through and re-edit the paradigms that had been erased since you lost the boss battle and had to retry. And that's what really killed the game for me, which was the cheese factor. Like, I definitely feel that Square Enix did that on purpose, and I think that really, in the end, takes away from the experience, the positive experience. I didn't mind the fact that the area opened up. I really loved that. But then even the way that they laid out their missions was problematic, and the way that the map marked the direction to go to complete quests was idiotic. In the end, Final Fantasy game, not a title.